Welcome students, in my new tutorial in which I'll teach you about self-referencing. Today I'll be teaching you how to use different type of self-reference and to use this method. The procedure is same for Excel or OpenOffice Calc. So self-referencing is the method by which you refer to a cell or series of cells in a formula. So I'll explain this concept by practicals. So moving further, the types of referencing. So there are basically three types of reference of cells: relative referencing, mixed, and absolute. So what's the basic difference between all three? So with the example, with this image, it will be clear to you. First definition, when you copy the formula from one cell to another, the relative cell address changes depending on the relative position of column and a row. Now for example, here you see, yes, this has been multiplied C2, D2. Now this is C2 and this is D2. So when it has been multiplied, C2 multiplied by D2. But what happens, just to save the time, we used to drag it by clicking here. When we drag it, automatically it changes. From C2, it automatically converts into C3. And here, where it was G2, it converts into D3. And the same, it happens here also. And it converts into C4. That means it gradually increases. So when it increases in this way, we used to say this is relative reference. In relative reference formulas, when it is copied, it changes itself. Now I'll move towards the mixed reference. So here also I'll explain with the example, but firstly the definition. In this type of referencing, one column or row is fixed. In relative, when we were copying the formula, the cell address was being changed. It was increased. But here, if you could see the example, H2 plus C$14. So means here, dollar sign has been put before cell number. That means row number. So this is not being changed. If you will see, when it is dragged down, H2 converts into H3, then H4, H5. But when we put dollar sign, it fixes the row or a column. But in this practical case, it is fixing the row. So sometimes we may need this kind of situation. So simply, with the definition, you can understand when either a row or a column is fixed, that kind of reference is called mixed reference. Third one is absolute reference. Now, in this type of reference, both column and row is fixed. So, and how it is being used? With the practical example, you could see here like B7 multiplied by $E$2. So, we used to fix both row and column by putting the dollar sign. This further I'll be explaining with the practical example. So now directly I'll be taking to the practical where I've used some random numbers and I'll show you how to use all these types of reference. Okay, coming back to the practical example. Now here I have taken profit and loss of a certain company, or you could say random company, in which I have taken month, earnings, expenses and profit. So firstly, how to calculate the profit? It's very simple. Earlier also we have done. So if I have to just deduct earnings from the expenses, the remaining amount will be the profit. For example, B3 minus C3, and this is the result. Now, if I see the formula here, this is B3 minus C3. And when I drag it, and if I'm dragging it down, you will see this B3 has converted into B4 and C3 is converted into C4. This kind of reference is called relative reference, where cell address is been increasing, it's been changed according to the situation. When I'm dragging it down, it is increasing row number wise. And here the same case, it converted into B5 and here B6. The same way, if I drag this side, right side, if I'll show you here, it converted into C3. Here it was B3. But when I have dragged it towards the right side, then what has been changed? This is column. Now column is being changed. Okay. So when I am dragging it down, row number is being increased. And when I am dragging right side, then column alphabet is being changed. So this type of reference is called, I'll just delete it. This type of reference is called relative reference. Because here, the cell address is being changed automatically. Nothing is fixed. Neither row number or column alphabet. Now suppose another situation. In this profit, I have forgotten to add rent. Suppose 5000. I want to add this one. So I have to change the formula. So in this formula, I'll add B3 minus C3 minus G2. I get the profit. But now when I'll drag it down, you see nothing has been changed here. It is 15,000 only. Why? If I'll just see the formula again, I'll press the F2 key. You could see now, because it is a relative reference, B3 converted into B4, C3 to C4. The same way, this G3, it is showing this side. It's empty, but it should show 5,000. So means I have to somehow fix this place, this cell address. And how I can fix it? By putting the dollar sign. So what I could do, when I was putting the formula here, I can fix the row number by putting this dollar sign. I press the enter key. Now you see the difference. Here it is 15,000. Now when I'll drag it down, it's been changed everywhere. And when I show you the formula, it's B4 minus C4 minus G dollar. So dollar means it has fixed this position, row number. Same way, if I show you here also, it's same. So I hope this concept is clear. So this type of reference is called mixed reference, where either row or column is fixed. Third position is absolute reference. When we put dollar sign before column also, this is the situation. Now here dollar sign is been put between before column. Now this means here column is also fixed and row is also fixed. And when I press enter key, although you may not find any changes here, but if I, just for example, if I'll dragging it this side and I'll show the result, only for showing you the formula, it is same. G will not change. Either moving down, either moving right side, nothing is being changed because row and column is fixed by putting the dollar sign. So I hope you are very much clear with the relative reference, mixed reference and absolute reference. So just try this, and still if you have any doubt, just post me the comments. So I am finishing my tutorial. Then bye bye.